Welcome back, everyone. Other questions on Node.js? I mean, there are thousands of questions. If you are expertise in Node.js, then you can answer them very easily. Right now, I'm just talking about the oral questions. Then we will also do some the hands-on code questions. So let's talk about some popular libraries or modules in Node.js. So there are some pre-built modules like Express to write the web framework. Okay. There is async modules to write the asynchronous operations. There is a socket.io for writing this, the writing and reading the streams. There is a FS module. There is a HTTP module to create a server. Okay, there is a .NET module to do the networking. There is a socket.io to do the stream stuff, and there is an Express module to write the web framework in Node.js and do the server-side rendering of different templates. So there are different things. Another thing is like how we deal with the events in Node.js. So there is an event emitter library and how to use it. So this is actually a core library which is coming with Node.js. So there can be a general question: what are the core libraries or what are the user-defined libraries? So in previous video, we created one module, right? So there is a user-defined module. Once we create a module, then we are actually requiring that module in another file. But like, these are the require events, which we are actually installing from the npm. So for that, I'm not doing npm install --- save express. So express library is actually predefined library, which I'm getting from node modules, from npmjs.com. So I'm getting it through the package manager. But you can also create your own module and can use that in a different file. That is a different things. And then the last thing is the core modules. For the events, you are not writing npm install --- save event, because it's a core module of Node.js which you can access directly. Okay. So let's create an event emitter object, which you can just get from events object. Dot event emitter. So this will give you the event emitter object, and you can write your events like event emitter dot on. So somewhere some event is emitted, and you can capture those events. And here will be the callback functions, and you will be capturing the event object and capture the data from. Okay, so this is the event emitter, and we are already know that Node.js is a event driven, and where we are actually doing the publishing and subscribing of the event. So the event emitter is the internal library of Node.js core, which is doing all these things. Similarly, we have the streams. So streams are there is a socket.io, and it is using the streams socket.io to read and write the data onto the different channel, or whenever we are writing the files, we are also using the read write streams to read and write the chunk of the data. So FS module is providing that feature. So you can just create a read or write stream from the FS module, which is also the core module. So this is FS, and if you wanted to read some data, so if you wanted to create a stream from that, like if I wanted to create a read stream from it, then I will do create read stream is their method. I don't know the exact name, but for that particular file, so you create a read stream. So whenever there is a data onto that stream, on data, you can write your own events. So whenever the data is coming, you can read that chunk information. Okay, console.log. So either you can just do chunking on that. Data is a global variable which you have, file data. Okay, So here this is how you can do the chunking, and whenever the read stream is getting over, then you can print on end. So whenever the file read is over, you can just do the console.logdata. Okay, so this is how we are creating the read stream and write stream in Node.js.